So the answer to the first part of this question is no, my boyfriend is not the one who gave me herpes. And then for the second part of this question, I have him right here so he can answer. So how do you feel about me having herpes and dating me?
Yeah, oh, it doesn't bother me. I think what bothers me is somebody lied to her about having it and then spread it. But, you know, you're always aware there's a little bit of inherent risk, but it's worth it. And, you know, she's the best, so it's not a problem.
All right, so there you have it.
He said, and I quote, "It's worth it. She's the best, so it's not a problem." Wow. Guys, is the bar set that low? Are men that thirsty? Are men that sex deprived? Do you not have options? See, this is what happens when you don't have an abundance mindset. You settle and date and get in committed relationships with women who have sexually transmitted diseases. Women who have slept around, who've been with a lot of different guys. I don't care about the complications that, oh, you could just take cream and pills and so you won't get, you know, any disease or you won't get any breakouts. No, forget that. A woman has something that she got from another man or other men, and she's carrying it to you, and you're saying, well, she's the best. You know, it's not a problem. I love her. This is my woman, so I'll just accept her for who she is. How nasty are you? How weak of a man are you? I mean, is your self-esteem that low that you can't even get any other woman that you accept? Literally trash. A woman who's tainted for life. And that's what you want? And you're dating that? And the fact that you're on camera, whoever this guy is, with this woman saying, well, I accept her, and ha ha ha. He almost looked like a zombie. Ha ha, I accept. That's just crazy, man. Guys, if you are in situations like that and you find yourself doing things that are not good for your health, you are going out of your way, doing crazy stuff to see a woman, to be with a woman. Basically, you're just overcompensating and you're putting yourself in bad situations. Leave. Look in the mirror says and ask yourself, why am I doing this? Why am I dating a woman who has an STD? Why am I with a woman who has contracted different diseases and different things from man? What about me is telling her and everybody else that I deserve this? He don't even know it's worth. Because if he did, he wouldn't settle for a woman like that. And on top of that, he wouldn't get on camera and let everybody know this is the type of creature that he's dating, that he's in a relationship with, that he wants to be with. The nasty secrets women hide from you guys is that they have STDs, they have STIs. See, women love to have unprotected sex. Don't listen, trust me, they love it. They're not gonna stop because it feels good. They love when that load gets shot in them. And I'm be honest, guys, a lot of women, if you even tell them, hey, I have this, if they're attracted to you enough and they have high interest, they would not even care about having raw sex with you. It's sad. It makes you want to throw up. But this is where things have come. Men are so desperate. They want love. They want companionship so bad that they resort to things like this. And honestly, he doesn't look like a bad looking guy. Look like he can get girls, right? So why is he with that female? Why is he with a woman who's trash, who has a disease that she's going to carry around for the rest of her life, and you don't know what else disease she has? Why would he suscept himself to that and open himself up to him having bumps on his genitals, him scratching and burning, and it burns when he urinates? Why would he open up himself up to that? You know why? Because he doesn't know his worth, and he defines his worth by being in a relationship. So when you define your worth and your happiness by being in a relationship with another woman, you're gonna allow her to do all types of stuff. You're gonna settle for anything. You gotta say, well, she's cute, or the sex is great, so she's the one for me. And to be honest with you, translation, basically what he was saying is, the reason why I say it's worth it, she's great, she's good, is because he's talking about the sex is worth it. This is what happens when you don't get sex often. You settle for trash, you settle for anything. Any woman that gives you some sort of feminine attention, some sort of validation, any woman who gives you sex, you just say, okay, well, this is gonna be the one for me. And I'm gonna be honest, most women have more sexual experience than the average man, by far. Their body count is far higher. So when a guy who doesn't, you know, hook up with women like that, who doesn't have experience, what's going to happen is he's going to get with one of those women who have high body counts and crazy experience in the bedroom. And since he hasn't experienced that level of sexuality, when she really puts it on him in the bedroom, he's gonna be like, oh, wow. Whew. I don't care if you had that STD. I don't care if you have that. Okay, you're mine. And he's going to be so smitten. He's going to be so in love. And he's going to look past all her flaws, all her diseases, all her nasty secrets, all her damage and baggage and everything, all her debt. He's going to look past all that because the sex is great and he doesn't get it that often. And he thinks he can't attract a woman who's quality. Because a quality woman doesn't have STDs and STIs. She uses protection if she gets down like that, but still, she doesn't. She's just not out here going in raw on different things. And yet, you can contract things if you do wear a condom here and there, but the chances are extremely low. So I guarantee you, that female that he's with, his girlfriend that he's so proud of, that he's dating, she was out here bouncing from dude to dude, going in raw, raw. They just pet, 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 just shooting loads at her. And she don't even care. This is what happens, man. When you settle for that, when you don't know your worth. Millennial women, they listen, they have the highest body counts. They are the most promiscuous because they think, okay, well, me being sexually open means I'm empowered. Means that I'm in tune with my body, that I love myself. Guys, if you are with a woman right now or you are having raw sex, I urge you to get a test, a full screening done, because it's your health that matters. She doesn't matter. Listen, that quick euphoria, that dopamine hit when you bust your nut, what does that really mean? Over, is that, do you take that over your health? I mean, what if she has something that's really detrimental to your health that can really erode and deteriorate? Yeah, they have different serums and pills and treatments that can, you know, kind of nullify the side effects, but still, why would you want that in your system, in your bloodstream? Just think about that. Here's the funny thing. She doesn't even respect him because he doesn't even respect himself. See, it looks like that, oh, she's happy and everything's cool, but deep down, she's looking at that simp like, you really accepted me that I have all these different things going on in my life? I have this STD that I can't get rid of? And she's looking at him like, man, you got to be a fool. But in his eyes, the simp, the beta male's eyes, he think that he's found gold. But he literally just went dumpster diving. I can see if he was like, okay, I'm smashing a chick on a low. She has something, but I'm not going to claim her. This man is claiming her. He's dating her. He's in a relationship. And he had the nerve to get on camera like this. Guys, go get a full screening. If you are going in raw with women right now, and you think, okay, well, I'm immune, I'm Superman, roo-rah, I ain't gonna get nothing. If I do get something, I'll take a couple pills and I'll be good. No, there's things out there that you can't get rid of. And it's going to be in your system for the duration of your life. And you're gonna be passing around to different people. Make sure you protect yourself. You not only gotta protect your health, but you gotta protect your seed. That's what really matters in life. Your health and your seed and your signature. Okay, so guys, make sure that you're not settling for trash, that you're not devaluing yourself, that you're not disrespecting not just yourself, your family, your last name, and your health, because that's just sick. Why would you, why, just think how weak you have to be, how inexperienced you have to be to settle and be with a woman who has something that she can't cure, that she can't get rid of. Now, no telling what else she has, but the fact is, still remains, he has low self-esteem. See, guys, it's not necessarily about your looks and everything, because he doesn't look like a bad-looking guy. Your self-esteem matters. Knowing who you are and your value matters. And honestly, he probably think, man, I just struck gold. But he literally is with garbage. How can Mir recover? You can recover by having standards, by being in control of your sexual urges. Because once you get control of that, you won't make silly, goofy decisions like that sucker did. I mean, look at him. And I guarantee you guys, mark my words, she either sleeping around with other guys or she's going to leave him and break up with him because he just looks like a beta guy. Just the tone of his voice and he just, like he's almost like a zombie, like he's a slave to her. This is what happens when you don't have any sort of standards, when you don't understand yourself, and when you are sex deprived and you think that, man, the minute she gives me crazy sex, this is the one. Heck, I've been there a couple times in the past, in my early years, where I got with a woman, the sex is crazy, and I didn't even vet her. I didn't do anything. I'm like, okay, well, she's great. Oh, wow, the sex is amazing. It's mind-blowing. And I'm trying to lock her down and be in a relationship with her. It's crazy. It's mind-blowing the things that you a man would do for sex, for companionship, for quote-unquote love. He will overlook a whole bunch of crap because he doesn't understand his worth and the value he brings to this world and to another woman's life. So he settles for trash.